ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय గీతామృతదుహె నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర, హూ ఇస్ సర్వజ్ఞ సర్వవిత్ సర్వశక్తిమాన్, బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ది ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. Let us begin Bhagavad-gita, verse number 28 of 9th chapter. Shri Bhagavan uvacha shubha shubha phalai revam mokshase karma bandhanaihi sanyasa yoga yuktatma vimukto mamu paishyasi. In the last words, Bhagavan Krishna gave a method how to sacrifice everything in the form of nishkama upasana. The beautiful words we have to by heart. Yat karomi yadashnami yajjuhomi dadami yat yat tapasyami bhagavan tat karomi tvadarpanam. That has to be the sentence, means a shloka, which we have to say every day while going to sleep. Because the activity what and all take place, because activities, though we plan every day, but whatever the incidents, accidents takes place, they are not in our control, isn't it? Whatever that I faced today, I offer all to your feet. That's what the meaning of the last verse. Now in this verse, the prayojana, benefit of that, once you started doing this kind of yajna, it's a complete sacrificing, it's a complete sacrifice. So when you sacrifice these things, you will get a complete chitta shuddhi, that which lead you for the next level, jnana yogyata. But also he has said subha subha phalai revam, he will overcome both. From the standpoint of papa, punya is moksha. Because as I told you before two classes, that we are born because of 50% punya and 50% papa. So we have to start working from the birth in order to neutralize papa. That's what the task is. All the difficulties which we get because of the earning already which we are born with. That is known as papa. The papa is the result from the last birth, that which brings the experience which only gives painful things. So now punya is there, therefore we get good parents, good teachers and good atmosphere. At the same time, we will get difficulty to merge with them because of our own papa. If we have fortunate enough from the childhood, you know, people are taken to temple. If you are very young kid, you don't have the knowledge how to earn punya, but automatically if your father and mother, means your parents or your society, are taking you to Tirumala or some other temples, Kailash or Manasarovar or Kedar, Badri, Gangotri, Yamunotri, Rameshwaram. So all this, going to the temple will increase your punyam and decrease your papa. You can neutralize the papa. So this activity must be began from the childhood itself, because once you want to get to know about your reality, it takes 15 years. Up to 15 years, a human being, it consumes all the knowledge. It is not clear enough to feel its own individuality. Though after 11 years we become conscious enough about our being, because we call it adult, you know, that adultery stage, still we were struggling to establish our personality. You go and you see all the students of 7th, 8th category up to college. People will be struggling to find their own personality. And especially nowadays, because of lots of influence, because the media and outside atmosphere, it's mobile, so they drastically bring changes in their personality. So people are very confused what kind of personality they should have, because they are driven in wrong ways. Now seeing all this media influence, so we have to think that we were fortunate enough, we were born early. No, I'm not talking in a negative way, but the fact remains as the fact, because there are schools, they don't allow any media inside. There are families, they don't encourage to have mobiles and all, but there are family too, they don't bother, they don't worry. There are schools, they give freedom completely. There where we have to take care of our own children. This is the responsibility of every parents, friends and society to take care of our youngsters. So youngsters from the childhood to be taught how to earn punya, that's what my intention, which I said, you know, for 10 minutes, for the past 10 minutes. So we have to be practiced. When we are born, Acharya says, Dullabham Trayamevaitat Daivanugraha Hetukam Manushyatvam Mamukshatvam Mahapurusha Samshrayah. He says, so to be born as a human being is very difficult, because we fought a long births, so many births, you know, thousands of births we took to get this human body. Once you are attained human body, you should be able to grow as a human. The Shastra says, when you are born, you are not considered as a human. We have to grow with the humanness, that humanity should supply that humanness. So you have to born as a baby, then you should grow as the human being, then you should get, you know, elevated up to the level of celestial being. That's what our lifestyle is. He says, to get human birth is very rare, very difficult. So even if you get the human birth, to grow with humanness, it's very rare. Manushyatvam. So among these humanness people also, to get attached with the marga, which leads us to spiritual life, spiritual destinations, they have to be introduced. There is a destination called Mokshaha. Then they would become mumukshu in a day. They have to be informed. Those people must have been informed. Have we been informed? No, never. In English, nobody has taught us there is a destination called moksha. That is what the proper destination. It may be not eye-catching. It may not attract us. But that is the proper destination. All other destinations are the stations, that which comes in between. You get and you buy something, you spend the time, but you get into towards train in towards the main destination. The main destination is the proper journey. Without fixing the main destination, life becomes meaningless. That's what to be taught. This is the second rarest thing to achieve. So it doesn't matter you are born as a human being, doesn't matter you got the humanness, but you should have the proper goal. That's what mumukshutvam. You should also set the desire towards the proper goal. Moksha. If you ask, you know, every adult, you just say, you know, do you know that your goal is moksha? They will laugh at. I don't want to get moksha. Just I need to get the ticket for the movie which is going to release on Diwali day. That's what the target is. Okay? That's what they think, that's moksha. Then how can you insist in them? Therefore, parents should have the responsibility in engage once he has become, he has grown, he cannot do anything. Before that, he should do. Let them go to a movie, let them go to wherever they want, but ask them to get connected with the main destination. So in between there are so many stations, doesn't matter. But aligning with moksha is important. Okay, that's what the rarest thing. And to get an acharya is the third last rarest thing. Maha purusha samshrayaha. You know, the world have seen lots of gurus, lots of shishyas, innumerable gurus. There is no defect in our Sanatana Dharma. So many gurus, still gurus are alive. But shishyas should have the fortunate enough to identify them. Either we make philosophy beyond our reach, or we make, either we make gurus as equal to the God, or we don't worry about them. You need to have the Sangha. You need to have a samshraya. Samshraya means you need to have the proper connection, the connection which fructifies the chemistry. There must be chemistry between you and Guru. That chemistry will help you to set the chemistry with the Shastra. The chemistry with the Shastra will create the chemistry with Ishvara. Whatever the God you wish to have the prayer with. But the chemistry should happen. That chemistry only comes, the first chemistry which you should have with the Guru. That's what Maha Purusha Samshrayaha. So after getting a proper Guru, after setting a proper chemistry with the Shastra, after having chemistry with Ishvara, you can have the Upasana. By following the Upasana as it was told in the last words, Yat karomi yad ashnami yad juhomi dad amiyat yat tapasyami bhagavan tat karomi tvad arpanam. That is the attitude. I am saying these words again and again so that you could by heart it. So that's a surrendering mantra. So every day, just while going, before going to the bed, you can do. Or with every actions. So if you are making any mission, you are accomplishing something, just offer it. Just offer to him. That's all it's needed. Then you will conquer both bonds. There are bonds. When you are born as a human being, you should conquer your papa. So you should be liberated from your own papa. For that you should have sakama bhakti. Sakama bhakti will make you to get liberated from papa. You will get punya. So once you get punya, then you should have the chitta shuddhi to get liberated from the papa. That's what known as purity of mind. So purity of mind means what? The mind which doesn't have any oscillations. The mind doesn't fluctuate towards worldly thing. Completely focused. Ekagrata chittam. That's what he says. Shubha, shubha, ashubha phalaihi evam karma bandhanaihi mokshase. You become free from bonds of all actions. All kinds of bonds you will be liberated from. It's a big, huge benefit which is not felt, which is not prized by the society. Nobody talks about it. Then sannyasa yoga yuktatma vimukto mamu paishyasi. After getting liberation, what happens? He becomes a sannyasi, the person who is endowed with yoga. The yoga means what? Nishkama karma yoga, nishkama bhakti yoga. So now in the first sixth chapter, nishkama karma yoga. Now in the second sixth chapter, it is known as nishkama bhakti yoga. So once you got nishkama karma yoga, you could be elevated up to the level of Nishkama Bhakti Yoga. So when you are elevated, then he says, he reaches me. He reaches me means what? He gets the status Jnana Yogyata. Carefully we have to understand that person will be elevated up to the level from where he can assimilate the knowledge of the equation Jiva Paramatma, Jivatma Paramatma Aikya Bhavana, where he can see God with an identical things. The perception that God and me are the same, that it needs lots of more tremendous upasana balam. Upasana balam means free from your own bonds. That's what upasana balam, known as chitta shuddhi in Vedantic language, or from the language of bhakti, achieving Bhagavan and reaching Bhagavan, attaining the glory of Bhagavan, or receiving the anugraha of Bhagavan. Okay, then what will he get? That's what is said in the next words. Let us read it. Samoham sarva bhuteshu name dveshosti na priyah ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya mayite teshu chapyaham. God himself clarifies. So once he gets that state, what will happen? Just he says, ye tu mam bhajanti bhaktya bhajanti mayi te teshu aham. It's a language. It's a kind of language which has got two corners, but two corners becomes one line. It's like, you know, they become equal to me. They get Ishwaratvam. Why? Because aham samaha. Aham sarva bhuteshu samaha. Mayi na dveshyaha asti na priyaha asti. They will get the state of Ishwaratvam. Ishwara doesn't have likes and dislikes. That's what they get. So one who worships in the form of Nishkama Bhakti, they will definitely reach me. They will find me in them. I find them in me. Farak nahi hota. Becomes they could feel the godliness in them. They could have the perception. Everything is God. Everything is nothing but God. And I am nothing but Ishwara. My body sense complex, all of them are nothing but Ishwara. Then in their mind, there won't be any likes and dislikes. Likes means it's limited, finite things. Dislike means same, it is finite things. They won't have that kalmisham. They will become very pure. That's what the glory. Here it is said, they will get the godliness. This completely purity of the mind. In the next words, he gets how it is true. If a person commits lots of sin, what will happen? After committing lots of sinful activities, suddenly he become bhakta. What will happen? Will it be acceptable or not? But he has become real bhakta. What will happen? Said here, api chet sudurachara bhajate maman anya bhak sadhureva samantavya samyagyavasito hisaha. So very important words, and these words has to be noted. These verses are giving complete clarity about so many things which are done in the name of bhakti. Okay, sudhucharaha api, duracharaha, sudhuracharaha. Durachara means a person with bad deed, a person who always goes with wrongdoing. The person who is criminal, who has got criminal tendency. What happens if he get into bhakti marga? If he grows to be a Nishkama Karma Yogi, Nishkama Bhakti Yogi, what will happen? Mam Ananya Bhak Bhajate. If he is using, understanding the words which was told in the verse number 22, Ananyaschintayanto Mam Ye Janapariyupasate Tesham Nityabhiyuktanam Yogakshemam Vahamyaham. Not thinking anything else, just keeping Bhagavan himself as the goal. He just forgets anything about his own life, like Ratnakaraha who became Valmiki. And in South there are so many rishis, even Tulasi Dasa, Sur Dasa and Purantara Dasa. And in Tamil Nadu there is an Arunagiri Nath. So many of these rishis, they were wrongdoers in their previous early life. Just they surrendered to Lord Ishvara. Just they could submit them completely. Sadhureva cha mantavyaha. From that moment when they surrender completely, they remove all these wrongdoing from their mind. Just they merge with my thought, my bhakti, they have to be considered as sadhu. Sadhu means what? That person who is committed to me. Those people have to be called bhaktas, devotee of me. Samyag vyavasito hi saha. Because he has got the determination with Nishkama Bhakti. Just he fixed me as his own life goal. He didn't want anything. They don't want anything than me. Therefore, they have to be considered as a sadhu, good people. Sadhu means you. If you are born in India, you will definitely know the meaning. Sadhu means a person who is nothing but a spiritual seeker, the person who wants to live his life. And sadhu means one more meaning also there. Sadhu means, we call it buddhu. Sadhu means very good person. The good person means sometimes, they are not good for anything. Good person. Bahut sadhu hai, kisi ko kuch bhi harm nahi deta, aur kamata bhi nahi hai, bechara hai. This bechara hai. It's not sadhu. Sadhu means one who follow dharma. Okay? Not harming others. Following ahimsa. Ahimsa, following, you should know how to follow the ahimsa. You should not harm any other creature. At the same time, you should not harm you. Okay? These two conditions. The third one also, you should not allow others harm you. That's what the life is. Not having enmity to anybody. Not applying harsh things. Just you be endowed with dharma is known as sadhu. How criminal people are. Once they get into this ananya bhakti. Ananya bhak means ananya bhakti. Bhas khatam ho gaya. Done everything what to be done. Krita krityaha. He has come. He has become Krita Krityaha. The Krita Krityaha means the person who is done with his life. He continues it. Kripram bhavati dharmatma shashvachantim nigachati kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati name bhakta pranashyati name bhakta pranashyati Name bhakta pranashyati. Note that line. Ma shuchaha yogakshemam aham vahami. Name me bhaktaha na pranashyati. My devotee never perishes. My devotee never perishes. He won't lose his life. It's a word is to be kept in the golden letters. That's what he continues. Immediately, in that second itself, he is converted as dharmatma. Shashvat chantim nigachati. He will just reach or attain a complete peace of mind. What is that complete peace of mind? And how can it is possible? They commit so many sins. Suddenly they jumped into the good deeds. Will it be possible? If in that case, the all criminals, one who has become sadhu, so the law won't affect them, then it is violating law alone. Anybody, you know, if they want to kill somebody, they can kill, then they can become sadhu. Is it so? No, never. Because always the law of Ishvara, the law of constitution, it goes parallel. Okay? So if you violate this law, you will violate that law too. If you violate Ishvara's law, you will violate this law too. Therefore, the constitution must be followed well. Then alone you can follow the supreme law. No doubt in it. We will understand this more clearly in the next episode tomorrow. Hari Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.